Good evening, my Trinity family, the Orangeburg community, and beyond. What a joy it is to announce the celebration of 156 years of our church's founding. The theme for 2022 is The Movement Continues, Transformation Toward an Even Brighter Future. The congregation of Trinity United Methodist Church worshiped in the T. Willie Lewis Chapel of Claflin College, now Claflin University, until a wooden tabernacle was constructed on the present grounds in 1927. The ground was broken for the new church in the spring of 1928, and the congregation moved into the basement in 1933. Little work was done during the Depression years until 1939, when the permanent floor was laid in the sanctuary. The first service in the completed structure was held on August the 20th, 1944. Music has been a vital part of worship from the beginning. Tonight, we will celebrate transformation through song. A concert by the renowned Jarvis Brothers, who are sons of Trinity United Methodist Church. Relax and enjoy.
I'm privileged to give you the reflections of some of the reflections of Trinity United Methodist Church. Trinity Methodist Episcopal Church was organized the first Sunday in January of 1866 by the Reverend T. Willard Lewis and the Reverend Thomas Phillips. The 1984 historical homecoming celebration of the church tells us that the first meeting was held in a schoolhouse built by Freedmen's Bureau, became the mark, the meeting place for the next 3 years. The duly elected officers of the church and those that follows received the title of the property on the corner of Amelia and Pittman Alley in the city of Orangeburg, and the property measured 280 feet by 225 feet and cost $400. A new church was built in 1870, authorized by the Methodist Church of the United States. It is rumored that the County of Orangeburg sought the property that the church was on because the courthouse had burned down to the ground. Meanwhile, the elected officials of Trinity Church also longed for the property near Claflin and South Carolina State College. In 1927, a wooden tabernacle was constructed, relieving T. Willard Lewis of the church presence, which lasted for a short while. I can recall sitting in the wooden construction with dim lights, wood shavings, and sawdust for a floor. Dressed in white clothing by my parents, there was also a lady bearing a long cane. To tap the young ones on the shoulders or the head if they became noisy and unruly. Ground was broken in 1928 for the new church. However, the wooden structure was still being used. The Great Depression slowed the construction, and the members entered the basement for worship in 1933-1934 after the walls and the roof were constructed. My fraternal grandparents moved from Greenville, South Carolina to Orangeburg to work in the construction of the new college for colored, as they were carpenters, and to establish themselves at Trinity, and to send their daughters to Claflin, as they were Methodists during the late 1800s. Of course, they joined Trinity at the Alley and helped build Trinity on the corner of Boulevard and Amelia. Trinity has stood the test of times of service in this community. She has instilled service to its members, young and old. I recall the Methodist Youth Organization, the Youth Choir, and the Boy Scouts. Mr. Hagler, the brother of Mrs. Maud Hagler, Mrs. Maud Lawrence, was my scoutmaster. Twice a year, he took us to the P.W. Whitcaid camp for camping during the weekends. I can visualize Maceo Gordon, Earl Middleton, and scoutmasters, along with Anthony Nimmons, Sidney Young, among others. In my mind's eye, I can further visualize the ladies of the church preparing for First Sunday and tutoring children to perform for Christmas, Easter, Children's Day, and Mother's Day. The encouragement of self-worth and self-esteem were instilled in us by Trinity Church. I can see Reverend McCollum, Reverend Matthew McCollum, beating everyone at ping pong and giving guidance to students during the civil rights of the 60s. The students moved towards downtown with a chicken bone in hand and determination in heart. My parents were married by Trinity's pastors, as were my wife and I, almost 67 years ago. Trinity is continuing to touch the lives of many of families as they come to receive their blessings and travel around the world. Let us all celebrate our existence of 156 years at Trinity United Methodist Church and move towards an even brighter future.
It began on the porch in Orangeburg, South Carolina, and now, some 50 years later, Ulysses, Rogers, Anthony, and Donald are still singing spirituals in 4- and 5-part harmony. They are the Jarvis Brothers, and their audience today has grown beyond Orangeburg to include the world. The brothers sing a cappella, and the strength of their unaccompanied voices have taken them to the Smithsonian Institute and the Kennedy Center for the Performing Arts, to churches and festivals across the South, where Jubilee, the Jarvis Brothers style, was born. Reginald Jarvis, the second oldest of the five brothers, died March 25th, 2007. The brother's nephew, Donald's oldest son, Cornell Jarvis, replaced Reginald in the quintet as the baritone voice.
Just a closer walk with thee.
Just a closer walk with thee. Just a closer walk with thee.
Glad
just a closer walk with thee. Just a closer walk with thee.
If you please.
Just a closer walk with thee. Just a closer walk with thee.
Daily,
just a closer walk with thee.
Oh, daily,
just a closer walk with thee.
With thee.
Just a closer walk with thee. Just a closer walk with thee. closer walk with thee.
Let it be.
Just a closer walk with
dear
thee.
Lord.
Just a closer walk.
Let
with
it be.
Just a closer walk with thee.
Credit their late parents, Ulysses Sr. and Anna Jarvis, for their success and longevity. They affirm the brothers' talents and encourage them to take to heart the wisdom of those spirituals that teach faith, patience, and persistence. The brothers were brought up singing in their family church, Trinity United Methodist Church of Orangeburg, South Carolina. In fact, their very first concert was encouraged and organized by the United Methodist Men. This presentation of the Jarvis Brothers comes as a commemorative of the 156th founding day of that church. The theme, the movement continues, transformation toward an even brighter future, celebrates that heritage in song.
Well, Ezekiel was in the valley.
It was on the Lord's day. Well, then the God called Ezekiel to prophesy.
Now,
hear me the words of the Lord,
the great God.
Ezekiel was in the valley.
It was
on the Lord's day.
Well, then
The God called Ezekiel to prophesy.
Now,
heavy the words of the Lord,
my Lord.
Ezekiel in the valley of the dry bones, Ezekiel in the valley of the dry bones, Ezekiel in the valley of the dry bones.
Now,
heavy the words of the Lord,
my Lord.
Ezekiel in the valley of the dry bones, Ezekiel in the valley of the
Lord, Ezekiel in the valley
of the dry bones. Now, heavy the words of the Lord.
They called Ezekiel the son of man, who preached the gospel to the sinful man. My God, stop and call Ezekiel. Hey, Ezekiel, go and prophesy. The people of Israel are going to die. Ezekiel went down to Israel land, preached the gospel to the sinful man. But the people of Israel would not hear. So my God said, the time is near. Gonna make me a city in my own way, with the nation of people that will obey. Then my God came in the middle of the night, destroyed the city with all his might. He put Ezekiel in the valley, prophesied, and
here is the word of the Lord.
Great God,
and the toe and the foot bone
join
together, and the foot and the ankle bone
join
together, and the ankle and the leg bone
join
together, and the leg and the knee bone
join
together, and the knee and the thigh bone
join
together, and the thigh and the hip bone
join
together, and the hip and the back bone
join
together. Now, here is the word of the Lord.
Great God,
and the finger and the hand bone
join
together, and the hand and the wrist bone
join
together, and the wrist and the arm bone
join
together, and the arm and the whole bone
join
together, and the fold and the muscle bone
join
together, and the muscle and the shoulder bone
join
together, and the shoulder and the collar bone
join
together, and the collar and the neck bone
join
together, and the neck and the jaw bone
join
together, and the jaw and the skull bone
join
together. Now, heavy the word of the Lord.
Great God,
them bone dry bones, them bone, dry bone.
Now,
heavy the word of the Lord.
Great God, they tell me when Ezekiel raised up his head, he thought he was lying among the dead. Then God asked Ezekiel, can these bones live? Ezekiel said, Lord, if it is thy will. Ezekiel began to prophesy. They tell me that the bones begin to rise. They tell me that he prophesied to the wind to blow breath in the bones that they might live. They tell me that the bones begin to walk. They tell me that the bones begin to talk. Then Ezekiel said, oh, these dry bones,
now heavy the words of the Lord.
Great God,
they walk, they talk, them dry bones,
they walk, they talk, them
dry bones, they walk, they talk, them dry bones. Now heavy the word of the Lord.
The Jarvis Brothers' style harkens back to the origins of African-American music on this continent. According to the International Gospel Music Hall of Fame and Museum, Jubilee dates back to the 1650s. The Gospel Music Hall of Fame acknowledges three distinct styles of gospel music then. Styles of gospel music were work in the fields, spirituals, and jubilee. Work songs were performed in the fields, and the timing of the songs is how slaves perfected their timing in the fields. The work songs were also coded language that allows slaves to speak to one another while excluding an overseers from their communication. Spirituals, stylistically, were akin to modern gospel. Slaves would sing spirituals to drums and stringed instruments. Jubilee is performed a cappella. Jubilee got its name from the Fisk University Jubilee Singers, a group that toured abroad in the 1870s to raise money for the historically black college. Jezebel, another arrangement by the Golden Gate Quartet, is an unforgiving song with unrelenting syncopate rhythm.
Jezebel,
Jezebel,
oh Jezebel,
God done forgot
tired of the wicked ways. All the angels in the heaven done a number of your days of the evil deeds God done got tired. You got to go to judgment to stand the trial. You got to go to judgment to stand the trial. You got to go to judgment to stand the trial.
Oh, Jesse.
You got to go to judgment to stand the trial.
God is tired.
You got to go to judgment to stand the trial.
God is tired.
You got to go to judgment to stand the trial. You got to go to judgment to stand the trial.
Well, stop, great God, stop still and listen. Ooh. Listen to the story about Jezebel. Her sins were so wicked, Jehovah got angry. The soul went a-leaping and stumbling in hell. Way back yonder in the olden days, God told the Jezebel about her ways. Say her evil deeds done ruined the land, and repent, for the kingdom of God was at hand. She got mad at John because he told about the gospel. She told the servants, stop all the mean all. But they tell me God peeped from the windows of the heaven, spoke one the word and all wouldn't bow. Clapped his hand, creation trembled, stamped his feet and time stood still. Raised his voice, looked down in thunder, John, go do my will. Jezebel, 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 oh Jezebel, God done, I got tired of your wicked ways. All the angels in the heaven done a number of your days of the evil deeds God done got tired. You got to go to judgment to stand the trial. You got to go to judgment to stand the trial. You got to go to judgment to stand the trial.
Well, they tell me John moved to the bowels of the gospel, told Jezebel the time was nigh. On the book of life her days were numbered, a time run out and she had to die. Then they tell me God moved his footstep thunder, he shook his head and his eyes flat fire, clapped his hand and death come a leaping. Jehovah was angry, somebody had to die.
Jezebel, oh Jezebel, death come a leaping at Jezebel.
Then death come a knocking on Jezebel's door, say,
come on woman, aren't you ready to go? Of the evil deeds God done got tired. You got to go to judgment to stand the trial. You got to go to judgment to stand the trial. You got to go to judgment to stand the trial.
Well, a soul went into leaping and stumbling in hell. Great God Almighty, I heard them tell. She lay 9 days on Jerusalem streets, her flesh too filthy for the dogs to eat.
Oh, Jezebel, 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 oh, Jezebel. God done, they got tired of your wicked ways. All the angels in the heaven done number your days of the evil deeds. God done got tired. You got to go to judgment to stand the trial. You got to go to judgment to stand the trial. You got to go to judgment to stand the trial. You got to go to judgment to stand the trial.
Other notable appearances of the group include a performance at the famed Apollo Theater in Harlem, New York, as well as before the cameras at South Carolina Educational Television during an ETV endowment pledge drive. They also performed for Nobel Peace Prize recipient, the late Desmond Tutu of South Africa. The group has been the recipient of numerous awards, to include the South Carolina Folk Heritage Award, the Distinguished Service Award of South Carolina State University, Kiwanis Club Award, the Orangeburg Chapter of the Lynx Award, the Elizabeth O'Neill Verner Award, South Carolina Black Hall of Fame Award, South Carolina African American History Calendar, and now this Jarvis Brothers arrangement of Swing Low, Sweet Chariot.
Swing low, sweet chariot, coming for to carry me. For to carry me home.
swing down chariot, stop and let me ride.
Swing
down chariot, stop and let me ride. Rock me Lord, come and easy. I've got a home on the other side.
Why don't you swing?
Swing down chariot, stop and let me ride.
Swing.
Swing down chariot, stop and let me ride. Rock me Lord, come and easy. I've got a home on the other side.
If you get there before I do, coming for to carry me home, tell
stop and let me ride.
Swing
down chariot, stop and let me ride. Rock me Lord, come and easy. I got a home on the other side.
Why don't you swing?
Swing down chariot, stop and let me ride.
Swing
down chariot, stop and let me ride. Rock me Lord, come and easy. I got a home on the other side.
Why don't you swing?
Swing down chariot, stop and let me ride.
Please swing.
Swing down chariot, stop and let me ride. Rock me Lord, come and easy. I got a home on the other side.
The Jarvis Brothers Quintet, throughout the years, has been reviving black spirituals, creating sincerity, and epitomizing the dignity of our musical heritage, and knowing that the movement continues. This Jarvis Brothers presentation is not complete without the proper ending. They call it the Amen Medley. A combination of amen, glory, glory, hallelujah, and will the circle be unbroken? All public domain spirituals.
Amen.
Keep singing.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah,
since I laid my burden down.
I shout better, so much better, since I laid my burden down.
I shout better, so much better, since I laid my burden down.
Will the circle be unbroken
by and by, Lord, by and by? There's a better home awaiting in the sky, Lord, in the sky.
Well, I
told the undertaker, undertaker, please drive slow, 'cause that body that you're carrying, Lord, I hate to see her go.
Will the circle
be unbroken by and by, Lord, by and by? There's a better home awaiting in the sky, Lord, in the sky. Glory, glory, hallelujah, since I laid my burden down. Glory, glory, hallelujah, since I laid my burden down.
On behalf of our minister, Reverend Dr. Eddie C. Williams, and the Founders Day Committee, I sincerely thank you for joining Trinity United Methodist Church of Orangeburg, South Carolina, for our 156th Founders Day celebration. Our theme, The Movement Continues, Transformation Towards an Even Brighter Future, recognizes Trinity's notable contributions through such outreach ministries as the Child Care Learning Center, the award-winning Boy Scout Troop number 190, and our rich heritage of discipleship, activism, and service. Our current edifice, listed in the National Register of Historic Places, was completed in 1944. About 4 years ago, our congregation embarked on the ambitious mission to restore our beautiful church to its original grandeur through our church restoration project. Much has been accomplished with the church's restoration project, the outreach ministries of the Child Care Learning Center, and Boy Scout Troop number 190. However, there is still more to do. We solicit your generous contributions to help in these endeavors. All funds raised for Founders Day will support the Restoration Project, the Child Care Learning Center, and Boy Scout Troop number 190. Again, thank you for supporting Trinity United Methodist Church. Please make checks payable to Trinity United Methodist Church for Founders Day, 185 Boulevard Street, Northeast, Orangeburg, SC, 29115, or donate online via our website, www.trinityumcorangeburgsc.com. Click Give Online button on the lower left. Again, thank you for supporting Trinity United Methodist Church.